Everyone, from the Greeks to Copernicus, assumed the orbits of the planets had to be circular. But in 1571, German mathematician Johannes Kepler shattered that assumption with our next great discovery. Lacking calculus, Kepler improvised ways to compute the circular orbit of Mars. The work was tedious. Kepler wrote that he was almost driven to madness considering and calculating the matter. His calculations began to reveal that the accepted notion of planets moving in circles simply did not work. Then a new idea came to him.
Kepler realized somehow the sun had to be driving the planets in some way that he didn't fully understand. And to get a self-consistent picture, he found that an ellipse was the path rather than a circle.
With this breakthrough, Kepler had devised the first method for accurately predicting the movement of the planets and stars across the sky.
When his tables predicted the planet Mercury to pass across the front of the sun, and nobody else's tables were close, that was dramatic proof of the accuracy of his astronomy. It linked the motions of the planets solidly to the sun. This was a very important point to help stress the idea that the Copernican sun-centered system really had physical significance.
And in the case of our next great discovery, his determination led him to revolutionize our knowledge of the solar system. The year is 1609. And Galileo is fascinated with a new invention called a telescope.
Essentially, it was a toy out of a carnival. When Galileo heard about it, he went to work making one. He perfected it and essentially converted a toy into a scientific instrument.
Galileo turned his telescope skyward and was the first to see the mountains on the moon and the star clusters of the Milky Way. Then an extraordinary sight. A group of four small bright stars arranged around the planet Jupiter.
We have the manuscript of his first week of observations. And it's wonderful because you see him gradually coming to the conclusion that these little stars are carried along with Jupiter.
This was the moment of discovery. Galileo realized that the stars were actually four moons orbiting Jupiter.
He had the insight that these moving dots were orbiting a planet.
I sometimes say he invented the satellites. And you say, wait a minute, they were there. How could he have invented them? He invented the idea that they were going around the planet.
Here was proof that Copernicus was right about the structure of the solar system. If moons could orbit Jupiter, then the Earth could orbit the Sun. And Galileo's discovery demonstrated that knowledge in astronomy can only be advanced by actual observation. A theory can only be viable when it's supported by the facts. Just like our next great discovery.